There are calls tonight to review the nation's dairy pricing code with warnings it's locking in higher costs at the supermarket. Processors say milk, cheese and butter could be cheaper if annual farm gate prices weren't imposed.
After years of drought, dairy farmers like Steve Ronalds are savouring their greener pastures.
It's just one out of the bag. Never seen anything like it. It's really unusual to get good milk prices and good seasons, and this is probably the second or third year.
As farmers enjoy more in their hip pocket, the cost of milk and cheese at the checkout has only moved up. The way dairy prices are set tonight under scrutiny.
I think the processors at the moment are probably getting hammered a little bit because they're just having to pay a lot more for the milk.
The companies making our staple products claim they're getting a raw deal because the minimum price they pay farmers is set in stone for a year. Last June, it was expected a dry summer would hurt supply. Instead, rain has led to a milk rush.
It's that challenge of predicting what the market is going to be. Putting your price and locking that in for 13 months carries quite a lot of commercial risk.
Processors calling for a review of the dairy code of conduct at odds with the farming lobby.
They put up a price, we accept the price. It sounds a fair and reasonable market transaction.
The government reluctant to intervene, but is weighing up tough action on supermarkets to benefit shoppers.
What they expect is to pay the cheapest possible price at the checkout, because people are doing it tough.
The Prime Minister will face his first major test of the year with a by-election set down for March 2nd in the Victorian seat of Dunkley, where voters will cast judgment on the government's handling of the cost of living. Eliza Edwards, Nine News.
And let's go live to Eliza Edwards in Canberra. Eliza, bad news for borrowers tonight. There's a new warning on interest rates.
That's right, Lizzie. The big banks might be predicting rate cuts later this year, but the International Monetary Fund is tonight calling on the Reserve Bank to push rates in the other direction. The global body warns further hikes may be needed to bring down inflation. It's currently sitting at 5.4%. The target is 2 to 3%. One glimmer of good news, the IMF is recommending new, well-targeted cost of living relief, so this will ratchet up pressure on the government to deliver more help to households.
Eliza Edwards there in Canberra.